Josie, this morning, Senate Majority Leader Paul Gazelka is facing a call to step down. It comes after he revealed Sunday that he has been diagnosed with COVID-19. And now a DFL Senate leader is asking him to step down.
Our Ben Henry is here now with more on this controversy and the latest on the state senator's battle with the virus. Ben.
Well, Chris and Megan, first off, Senator Gazelka says he is feeling fine and he expects to get better. This is now the second Senate GOP member to test positive for the virus. And this morning we're learning there are a couple of events that have happened over the last week or so that possible spread to other members of the party may have happened. Let's talk about those as we break this all down. The first one being a cabinet meeting on the 5th. Days later, Senator Dave Senjem, who was at the meeting, tested positive for the virus. Several staffers have also tested positive. GOP leadership warned those who were there and others within the party, but no one else. We've learned that there was a post-election party as well where potential spread may have happened. Just last Thursday, a special session was held. Senator Gazelka was not at the meeting and said no one was put at risk, and those who may have been exposed were told not to go in person. But the issue this morning that DFLers have is with the lack of communication and warnings about the cases. Because of that, and what she calls a lack of leadership, Minority Leader Senate Susan Kent is calling for Senator Gazelka to step down as majority leader, something he tells our Tom Hauser he has no plans of doing. Now, Governor Walz has weighed in on this as well. He is not happy about what has happened, not happy about the lack of communication, calling this a nonpartisan issue that put many people at risk. The governor has a few events on the docket today, one including some press availability. So I imagine he'll be pressed on this. And again, despite Senator Gazelka letting our Tom Hauser know he has no plans on stepping down, I doubt this is the last time we'll be talking about this morning. We're live outside the Capitol. Ben Henry, 5 Eyewitness News.